gardener series for dummies, because I'm a dummy. Okay, so I'm not instructing dummies what to do. I'm a dummy and I'm trying to figure out what I need to do. So this house that I bought, it came with a garden, right? It's a raised bed garden, and it is 24 feet by 16 feet. So obviously it has grown up with weeds. So from my cousin, who is my garden aficionado and has a degree in agriculture, and he's a country boy, he's like, I need to pull the weeds first and then till it. So I started yesterday, but then I started at like 3 o'clock, so it was hot as hell. And it's February, mind you, in case you're wondering, okay? And so this morning I got out here before it gets super hot. Yeah, I'm out of breath. But this is work. This is exercise. This is a labor of love, okay? My house also has, you see those two over there? Those are pear trees. And these four back here are peach trees. So they had fruit last year, but we just moved in. I ain't have time or the energy to be, you know, harvesting the fruit. So this year they'll flower. That's how fruit trees do. I think it's every other year or every couple of years. They flower on the in-between year. So I won't have any fruit, which will be fine because that'll give me time to focus and get this garden together. So once I get these weeds pulled up, my next step will be to go to Home Depot or Lowe's and rent a tiller. So I'll be back. But I'll put like the first steps in one video, and then planting will be a separate video and all that. So I won't have a bunch of like 2-minute videos, because that'll make no damn sense. Bye. Oh, y'all want to see my get up for the day? Yes, sexy, sexy with the boots. Yes, sexy. Hey, hey. Okay. A lot of me saying, well, my cousin said, because I just decided that he is going to be my garden person. So he said I need to get the weeds up from the root as much as I can, and then the tiller will get rest of the weeds up. So I'm using my shovel to kind of dig down here and just lift it, right? So I'm going around because that's quick, and then I can just bend down, pick up the weeds, and shake the dirt off, because I don't want to throw away the dirt because it's actually been planted in before. So it's, what do you say? It's seasoned or primed for planting again or something. I don't know, something he said. So I'm shaking the dirt off, but I'm trying to get these roots out, weeds out from the root. So here I go. So it got hot that day, and then it started raining like maybe the next weekend, and every time I was going to finish it, it was something else that would come up or I wouldn't feel like it. So 3 weeks later, and I finally got all of the weeds out of the garden. Yay me! So now what's next? It's tiller time! I went to Home Depot and rented this small tiller for $38 for 4 hours. And got to work. But it took me a minute to figure out how to cut it on, even though it turned on right away in the store. You know, time you get it home, then all of a sudden stuff don't want to work quite right. So I finally got it with the choke on or the choke off. I forgot what the lady said down to the store. So I finally got it together. And let me tell you something. When I hit the daggone lever to get it going, and that sucker start churning and tilling that dirt, I felt the blood of my ancestors. I felt the spirit of my great-grandfather come in me, and it was just awesome. And I've never been a yard person before, but now all of a sudden I feel like I could have acres and maybe have a mule and hook up a till to him and just keep it. I mean, this thing was empowering. I just absolutely loved it, to the point where I feel like I need one, but I don't. I know I don't, but I feel like I would like one, but I'm not going to get one. But I just had to tell you how excited this made me.
Next up, it's time for lime. So based on all of the research and advice I've received, I know that I need to put lime down on the garden, which makes the soil fertile and healthy or something. I don't know exactly. So I caught myself going to get my cedar, which I've had for a long time, but didn't realize that it doesn't push well. It doesn't work pulling it as far as spreading the lime. So pushing it in this thick, supple dirt didn't work well either. I was really struggling. So I decided that, hey, why don't you just grab the lime and throw it out in the garden, since I'm going to have to till it in there anyway to really get good coverage. So that's what you see me doing here. Just grabbing handfuls, throwing it out. Maybe it's not even. I'm sure it's not even. But I'm sure, again, the blood of the ancestors, okay, will take care of the parts that I'm missing as far as process. Uh-huh. Yes. So next is to throw out some cow poo. So I went to Lowe's and they told me to get black cow manure to throw out there. So this is me doing the heave-ho to get that bag out of my trunk and carry it into the backyard so I can throw out the manure. It says it's composted, so there was no smell. So I didn't have like a backyard smelling like poop. So what I decided to do was just dump out the whole bag and then take my shovel. I have a flat shovel, and shake that out or kind of throw it across the garden, so that way my next step is going to be to till it again, and then my garden will be ready for planting. So that's what you see me doing here, taking my flat shovel and just kind of throwing it out. I ended up with two bags. I probably could have done with three is my guess, but I feel like it'll be okay. The soil has been planted in before, and so it's enriched. I forgot what that word is my country cousin told me about. But anyway, it should be good to grow with just the two bags that I got. And I think for the cost of the two bags was like $11 something. The bag of lime was maybe $5, $6. So thus far, I have not spent a lot of money on this project. The most expensive thing was the tiller. Written that for $38 plus tax came to $44, whatever. But it'll be all worth it in the end, I'm telling myself. Last but not least, it's time to till it again. I love the tiller. Like, I just wanted other stuff to till that day, but I didn't have anything else that needed to be tilled. I didn't have any neighbors that needed me to come till. Like, I feel like I could have a part-time tilling job and just buy the tiller and go around and till other people's yards, because that's how much fun I had. But the next day, my body was sore from just trying to wrangle that thing. But it was a good sore. It was like, ooh, you did real work and you're creating a garden that's going to nourish your family type of soreness. You know, I don't know. Anyway, it just made me excited. So next, in my next video, which is going to be part two, we're going to talk about these railroad ties, because I did a little research to replace the railroad ties, and boy, did I go down a rabbit hole of information. So hopefully you guys will stay tuned for the next video. See you later.